Testimony, I don't know if I can stop that. That was deep. You can, I hope everybody heard that message, because she was talking from her heart, her experiences. And I know a lot of people in my voice have been going through the same experiences that she went through, but she made the right decision to come to Jesus, and look at her now. Jesus said, lay your burdens on me. You who are weary and heavy laden, for my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. It's nothing in this world that Jesus can't take off of you. Nothing in this world that he can't take off of you. I was going to be a murderer, an adulterer, a fornicator, an alcoholic, a liar, a thief. See, I was stony heart. God said, I will take that stony heart away from you and give you a heart of flesh so you can fully understand me and know of my glory. Know of my glory. Jesus can take everything. You know what Jesus said about your sin? I got to hear this. You know what Jesus said about your sin? Jesus said, when you come to me, I will take your sins and cast them into the depths of the sea and remember them no more. You will remember your sins no more. Imagine that. Imagine having all of your sins cast. Let me ask you a question. You see these chains that I'm wearing right now? If I toss these chains, this pair of chains into the depths of the sea, what are the chances of me finding this the next day or the next week? One out of 2,888,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, gone, it will never, ever, ever have it no more. Amen. Amen. And out of my own childhood, I was raised without a mommy and without a daddy, and I hit the streets when I was 11. Why do you mean Mount Pleasant? I'm an old dude from Mount Pleasant. My old neighbor, my old dude from Mount Pleasant. I was born at Mount Pleasant when I was 11 and 12 years old. Amen. But you know what? I didn't care about what the direction I was going. I only cared about what I could do. You know what I'm saying? It's all about me, me, me. And it's been like that since I was 48. When I turned 48, everything changed. You know what I'm saying? But I've been through the rough part of life. I was in despair. You know what I'm saying? I was in love and betrayed. I ran in the game. I used to wake up every morning too late to hit the liquor store. I'm the first one at the liquor store. I couldn't wait to hit the liquor store. Beer was my idol. I lived for women. Women were my idol. I lived to go to the club. The club was my idol. Amen. Those are idols. Amen. Those were all idols. Until I came to the end of myself. And when I came to the end of myself, for the first time in my life, I asked for Jesus. I asked for Jesus. And Jesus changed my whole life around. Jesus. But imagine if I didn't ask for Jesus, I would even be right here right now. I mean, if I respect Jesus, because it's a difficulty asking and accepting. A lot of people take God's name in vain. And a lot of people ask Jesus for stuff. But they're asking the wrong thing. You're asking for the wrong thing. You need money? Don't ask. Because the scripture says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. and the stress will be added to you. I'm not saying that you can't have good things in life, even as a Christian, but seek God first and you will have the best. That's what that scripture means. Amen. And boy, oh boy, my prayer that I asked Jesus and I expected Jesus that day. Because if I had any glory, if I didn't ask for Jesus and accept Jesus as my Lord and personal Savior, and confess all my sins, and acknowledge to God the Father that Jesus Christ is the King of Kings and that He rose from the dead, and He is in heaven sitting at God at the right hand of God, if I didn't confess all these things and do these things, I didn't have any dead or locked up. Dead or locked up, whatever comes to us, because that's where I was headed in my life. That's where I was headed. But glory, glory, and hallelujah to the Lord for hearing my call and answering my call. And it was not me that answered this, because He removed all of my sin. He set me free. He opened my eyes so that I can see. He died on the cross so that my soul will not be lost. All these things He did for me, because He wants me to live with Him eternally. And it's a done deal. It's a done deal. Because no matter what happens to this world or in this world while I'm still in it, I am never turning my back. You know what God said about a Christian who drinks to their sins? It's like a dog looking at his own vomit. That's how God feels about that. When you return back to your sins, that's also called blasphemy. Amen. So I hope that my testimony and my sister's testimony, for those that were listening, can help you to decide or bring you to a fair conclusion to come to Jesus someday. Because I'm going to be honest with you all right now. Life is not guaranteed. Our life on this planet is not guaranteed. Nobody knows where they want to be tonight or tomorrow morning or next. 20 minutes from now. But God knows everything, but He's omniscient, omnipotent, and omnipresent. There's nothing you can hide from God. Nothing you can hide from God. Instead of running from God, why don't you run to God? Amen? Am I right about it? Because Jesus is the Lamb slain who overcame, and He's coming back once again to reclaim the kingdom of His name. Amen, amen. And I said in His name, amen. I said amen myself. I'm so glad to be here. Yes, that's Jesus in a nutshell. The Lamb slain, because He died on the cross, who overcame, because He overcame death, and He overcame Satan. Amen? And He's coming back once again, because He's going to gather up His church, and He's going to come back and He's going to say, I'm not saying you're going to come like that. And He's coming back once again to reclaim the kingdom of heaven. Amen. Amen, amen. So make your decision today. Choose wisely. You know, Scripture says, choose today who you shall serve. Stop worshiping these idols out here. Stop worshiping the Pope. Stop worshiping the Virgin Mary. Muhammad can't save you. Gandhi can't save you. A peaceful confession of this can't save you. I wish I would see the baby. Confess your sins to a priest. How are you going to confess your sins to a priest in the booth? And he's a man just like you. And God the Father says, come to me. Confess to me your sins. If a priest in the booth cannot save you. Amen? So take heed and know that the truth is Jesus. The truth is Jesus.